Hi everyone, and welcome to YouTube and Peter Grant Fine Art, and hope you enjoy this fairly long video that I'm going to do. I'm working on Harry, happy puppy, and I'm doing it for Therapy Partners and the Da Vinci Dogs, which is a fundraiser that I've been supporting by painting different members' dogs, and the funds from those images and paintings that are arrived go to support various activities. And still got a lot of work to do, and I got a short time to get it done in, so I plan to be working all night tonight. And basically what I'm going to try to do is get this thing well to the you're done stage. But I've been working already for about an hour and a half, and part of what I've been working on is trying to bring Happy Harry's face to some sort of realism. And of course, many of you know that what I paint isn't always intended to be realistic. But for something like this, I do want to at least have the owners of the puppy be able to look and go, oh yeah, that's our baby. And again, some of that is an issue that I deal with, because as I've always said, I'm not a realistic painter, nor do I try to be. So right now, I'm trying to put a bit of realism in to a painting that hopefully that it brings some life to the painting, and hopefully the owners will look and say, oh yeah, that's our baby. So we'll see how this works out as it continues. And one thing my wife was excited about was the sunset in the trees, which I am excited about it too. And Harry is a hunter, and a bird dog type hunter. And so he's taking a break as the sun's setting out in the pasture. And so things are going pretty well for him. Everything's happy. And kind of need to give him a little bit more body here. I noticed the other day when I was looking at it, I was going, yeah, that doesn't sound right. Or doesn't look right. So we're going to give him a little bit more body and fill him out some. And we do have a thunderstorm going on, and Roxy and Hoss, and right now you're hearing Hoss warning everybody in the house that the thunderstorm is rearing up again. So That's Roxy, the high-pitched one. They work it as an unbelievable team. Gotta keep bringing more butt into this puppy. I don't want to go too far and then say, oops, I went too much, but I do want to keep bringing it up, so I'm bringing it up a little bit at a time. And I think I'm finally at the point that I want to be. This right here is going to have to be more of the orange field, kind of like when I start slapping paint, it just kind of gets carried away a little bit too much. So I may have to unslap some paint. But, I think that'll be good. I'm excited. And yes, unique experience here is I do use some paper plates from time to time. Kind of actually mix the colors before I put it on the canvas, which is something that I tell you that I don't normally do. Right now I'm looking for the darker shade of brown paint. But, by the way, my son's coming tomorrow, and he recently retired from Pacific Northwest Ballet. Recently, it's been about a year and a half now. And he now has his own dance company in Seattle. And he's coming to visit, and I'll tell you more about that a little bit later. But right now I'm going nuts because I can't find the dark color paint. Let me step away for it because I know I had it right here. Well, probably my issue is Roxy must have eaten it. Ah, there it is. It's on the floor. I'm trying to play a little bit of Carolina Beach music in the background, which has been, I'm on YouTube and I say, play Carolina Beach music, and they have no idea what I'm talking about. I finally got them to play the Embers, but now we're playing Motime. That's kind of almost in the mix. Carolina beach music is not soul music. And one thing I'll tell you that it's definitely not, is it not beach music like they play in California. Okay. Or down on the Gulf. Beach music, Carolina beach music, comes from Carolina, along the South Carolina and North Carolina coast, right at the great state of, and of course everyone knows what the great state of is. Well, the storm's moving in a little bit more, so the puppies are getting concerned. I do have a couple of photographs that are right here on my iPad. And right now I just have one up. But to give me an idea, usually or quite often I'll have more than one. And the idea of having more than one is what helps me keep from making everything exactly right and working on the detail. I'm not the one for detail, but I think I'm gonna try to do this one fairly quick under the thing here and stop this video at about the 15 minute mark. If you go to my website, you can either get there by going to petergrantfineart.com or just go to petergrantart.com. Both of them will take you to that site. And if you haven't already seen it on Facebook, if you go to the, on my webpage, go to Peter Grant Art, and look for the cat and dog fights. And with the cat and dog fights, you'll see all my paintings that I've done of dogs and cats. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna hit the timeout button. Hope you enjoyed this, and I'll be back shortly. This is Harry, and I'll probably call it Harry number one. And my boss just showed up behind me. Thank you.